everyone, this is Doxy Mom, and welcome back to my channel. If you haven't done so already, I greatly appreciate if you hit that little red subscribe button. You can ring the bell for notifications, and if you like this video, just give it a thumbs up. Well, Miss Indy and I, we're here to bring you the news in 15 minutes or less, so let's get started. Now, guys, today's going to be a little shorter report. I had quite a bit of company yesterday, and it took me 3 hours to upload yesterday's video. Some things are going on with the Wi-Fi. Anyway, I just didn't have a lot of time to do a lot of research. Now, 17 was posting like crazy. My phone just kept blowing up. But in post 3918, 17 questions. If it's difficult to imagine that the media and the Democrat Party are willing to sacrifice lives in order to regain power. Now, that's just awful, isn't it? But we know that they do not want us to find a cure for the coronavirus. They want to have people remain fearful and panicked and scared. And yes, they absolutely will let people die to carry out their agenda. We mean nothing to them. We're just sheep in their eyes. But 17 reminds us that difficult truths will soon see the light of day. The hunters will become the hunted. And these people will be punished. So I will link QMAP, and you can go over and see all of the Q posts, or you can tune in to iPod and Praying Medic. Those are my two top favorites to watch as Q decoders. Now, Sean Hannity, he predicted there will soon be major developments related to the deep state revealed to the public. Hannity goes on to say, there's so many developments with this deep state. Wow, it's about to blow wide open. I can't wait to watch. Well, neither can we, Mr. Hannity. Anyway, in yesterday's report, I had shared two articles on John Durham that 17 guided us to. And, you know, I was wondering why 17 was bringing up Durham. And then I saw this article. So hopefully Durham's report will be out very, very soon. Now, in this article in the Washington Examiner, it said that the Wall Street Journal reported Durham's review is putting increased scrutiny on former C_A director John Brennan, searching for any undue influence he may have had during 2017's intelligence community assessment of Russia interference. Well, in my opinion, Brennan spied on everybody. He hates America, and he's a traitor to our country. Allegedly, but that's just my opinion, and I'll leave a link. Now, just a heads up, guys. Kamala Harris could be Biden's running mate. Y'all all know how I feel about her, but the good news is we're all going to get out. We're going to vote, and President Trump will be our next president, and it's already been prophesied, so we have nothing to worry about there. Now, Out of the Shadows, this is a documentary that will air today. Mike Smith, a former Hollywood stuntman, produced this with his own money, and it exposes the evil in Hollywood. Now, I don't know what time that they will release the video so you can view it, but it will be released today, and I will link it, and please, please share it with others. Well, today is Good Friday, and if you haven't watched the movie Passion of the Christ, I highly recommend you do that, but make sure you have lots of Kleenexes on hand. If you have seen it, just please think about the sacrifice that Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, you know, that sacrifice that He made for us that day on Calvary, because He shed His perfect blood and died for us so we could be forgiven of our sins. And because He rose on the third day and lives, we can have eternal life in heaven with Him. So I'm going to leave you with Luke chapter 23. I'm going to be reading about the crucifixion, verses 32 through 46. Two other men, both criminals, were also led out with Him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified Him there, along with the criminals, one on His right, the other on His left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." And they divided up His clothes by casting lots. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at Him. They said, "He saved others. Let Him save Himself if He is God's Messiah, the Chosen One." The soldiers also came up and mocked Him. they offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above him which read, "This is the king of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God?" he said, "since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Truly I tell you, today you will be in paradise with me." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, for the sun stopped shining, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." When he had said this, he breathed his last. Well, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for tuning in. And until next time, this is Doxy Mom, and God bless you all.